Hi, in this video I am going to discuss the topic Introduction to Chromatography. Chromatography is actually a combination of two Greek words called chroma and graphene. Chroma means color and graphene means to write. Color to write is the meaning of chromatography. Then what is chromatography? And why we are using chromatographic methods? Chromatography is a separation technique and it is used to separate complex mixtures. So what is complex mixtures? Actually complex mixer is a mixer whose components get more and more similar in physical and chemical properties. It becomes increasingly difficult to separate them from one another. Example, amino acids resemble one another rather closely in physicochemical properties. In order to separate them, we use chromatographic methods. What happens in chromatography? The complex mixer is dissolved in a fluid called the mobile phase, which carries it through a structure holding another material called stationary phase. These are different types of chromatographic procedures. First one, partition chromatography. Second one, adsorption chromatography. Third one, ion exchange chromatography. Fourth one, gel filtration chromatography. Fifth one, affinity chromatography. Partition chromatography. When a solute is allowed to equilibrate itself between two equal volumes of two immiscible liquids, the ratio of concentration of the solute in the two phases at equilibrium at a given temperature is called partition coefficient. According to this partition coefficient, the flow rate of components in a mixture changes, thus the separation takes place. Paper chromatography works under this principle. Adsorption chromatography. Components of a mixture differ in their adsorption and desorption behavior between a moving solvent in the sense liquid or gas, and a stationary solid phase. This behavior of a component can be used for its separation. Thin layer chromatography is an example of adsorption chromatography. Ion exchange chromatography. It is defined as the reversible exchange of ions in solution with ions electrostatically bound to some sort of insoluble support medium. The ion exchanger consists of an inert support medium coupled covalently to positively or negative functional groups. If the support medium coupled covalently to positive functional groups, then it is called anion exchanger. And if it is covalently coupled to negative functional groups, then it is called cation exchanger. To these covalently bound functional groups, which are bound through electrostatic attraction, the oppositely charged ions, which will be exchanged with like charged ions in the sample. Thus, if anion exchange chromatography is performed, then negatively charged sample components, which will interact more with the stationary phase and will be exchanged for like charged ions already bound to the matrix. These sample ions will be retarded, whereas other uncharged or positively charged ions will not be retarded to the same degree and will be eluted out fast. Molecular size gel filtration chromatography. This separation is according to the molecular size. A gel consists of porous beads where pore size is strictly controlled, macromolecules smaller than the pores get entrapped in the pores and move slowly, while those bigger than the pores travel undisturbed through the column and elute out faster than the smaller molecules. Affinity chromatography. A substrate analog for enzyme is coupled to the gel matrix and the cellular suspension is allowed to percolate through. The enzyme which is specific for the substrate analog binds to the gel and become immobile, while other components move down and out. This technique has very high resolution power. Column chromatography is an example of this affinity chromatography.
Thank you for watching this video.